How's it going, folks? Setting up the barrels behind me here. They're sort of a take on a Dutch bucket. Not exactly the same, but very similar. The reason I'm making these guys up is because I'd like to try to grow some ginger. I know it grows well in aquaponics. I've seen a chap in Australia here do it rather well. So what I thought I'd do is remove them from the grow beds as such, the larger grow beds, put them in individual barrels and see if we can grow a half decent crop there. I didn't really want to do a flood and drain style grow bed. I thought I'd give the Dutch bucket style a crack. That's basically where you have a drain in the base and just a trickle of water constantly flowing through the media. The barrels, pretty easy to make up. I mean, all I did was grab the jigsaw, chop them in half. They're a 55 gallon barrel or 200 litre barrel, so it gives you a fairly sizable volume of media to grow in. I'm hoping that they grow fairly well in there, so we get, you know, probably two or three plants per pot, but you'll probably see that by the end of the clip. I suppose I'll give you a bit of a look at where we're up to with it. So this is the stand that Dad made up, just out of the school fencing from across the road. The neighbour and I liberated it a while back, they were just going to dump it. We were actually going to make this fence out of it, but they scored some collar bond and made that one. It's a pretty nice looking bench. He's done some pretty schmicko welds on there, made it all nice and smooth. It's sitting on the pallet tread or the base of an IBC tank cage at the moment. It's just got a bit of treated pine under there to give it some more height. The reason behind that is Dad's being a bit of a perfectionist here, and what he wants to do is put stainless steel plates on the feet and have some legs that go up inside there so I can adjust the height. I'm not knocking it. It's gonna be a very useful piece of equipment once they're in place. But for the time being, just sitting them on there, the barrels, both barrels are gonna have handles in them, so we'll be able to lift them down, put the feet up, and then put it all back together. Won't be too hard to do once they're built. A couple of cross rails put in situ rather nicely. They're just to take the weight. I mean, this is really overkill. This is inch and a half or inch and a quarter pipe. It's really heavy duty stuff. Just down the center here, I've just tentatively wired on the drain because I have to take it off. I need to drill some holes in there in a minute and I need to take the swarf out. So that's just around the corner, glued fitting there, open end directly into the sump. And on the end here, I have a threaded on cap. These fittings here, I can actually put another section of pipe in there to extend it and glue it, but I've just got this option in there as a bit of a way to stick a hose down there and just blow out any gunk that may accumulate. It's on a pretty good angle, so I don't think we're going to have any problems with that. Hopefully, there's going to be no gunk coming out of it anyway, but you never know. I'll just set these barrels up and give you a bit of a look at them. So the barrels are just going to sit on top of the bench there, and then the drains will just come out and run straight down into the pipework there and then away to the sump. The way these are set up is pretty basic. So what we've got there is the drain assembly. It's a section of 90mm downpipe or stormwater drain. I've cut some slots in it using a grinder. I've put a hole in the top that is large enough to take the 25mm or 1-inch fitting, and that just sits in there loosely. On the end I have a couple of end caps just held in place by 316 stainless steel screws, and that fits nicely onto a pipe with another 316 stainless steel screw keeping it in place, and there's no way that's going to come off. It's all just sitting there loosely. The reason I like these screws is because I can take these apart, pull the assembly apart, and if I decide to redesign the barrel, I haven't lost any plumbing whatsoever. It's all reusable. To put these together is pretty easy. I've sort of half done one. I thought I'd just give you a bit of a quick look. For the Uniseal itself, this is a 1-inch one, so I used a 1¾-inch or 44mm hole saw. Just zapped a hole in the side of the tank, cleaned off any of the burrs on the outside with a utility knife. Next, the drain pipe was cut and inserted through the Uniseal. It helps to give the seal a little bit of lubrication just with a little bit of water. And then, yeah, basically give it a bit of a shove through and, if need be, help it along with a rubber mallet. So all I need to do is get my 25mm elbow, or 1-inch elbow, just push him straight onto the pipework there, and that's going to stay in place. That's locked in place. I just need to zap a hole down through here, put the screw in, and away we go. That drain's fit. For the drain assembly on the outside, of the barrels. I've wrapped some cheap white plumber's tape, Teflon tape, around the pipe that's come through the Uniseal. That's just to, you know, make sure that the fitting isn't going to leak at all. To hold it all in place, I've just zapped through a 316 stainless steel screw, and then I've cut a hole in the drain pipe that takes the water away to the sump, cleaned out all the swarf, and pretty much we'll just put in an appropriate length of pipe. I think one was 6 inches and one was 7. What's that? 15 and about 18 centimetres. And then I've done the same thing, wrapped some Teflon tape around the pipe, zapped through a 316 stainless steel screw, and hopefully that should be childproof. If anyone comes and gives a bit of a wiggle on the pipe, they should all stay in place. There we go. These guys are pretty much all set up. Now to arrange some water flow from that little cap there. That little cap is screwed onto the top of the pump. I'm going to have it run up there, along here, then across, and then over to these two beds here. So I've got my little baskets and trays of goodies down there, so we'll get into it. So there you go, guys, I've actually finished it, but I'll walk you through the plumbing and whatnot. I've already got the ginger in there, got 3 ginger in each barrel, but I'll walk you through the plumbing. This is the feed line that comes off directly from the pump in the sump. For now it's just running to these two barrels, but eventually it'll be going to the new beds and the NFT that's being built to go there. So it's just running up this black line. I have a master valve here. Everything's held on with 316 stainless steel hose clamps so they don't go flying with the pressure. I've glued up some 20mm or 3/4 inch PVC fittings. Just used what I've got lying around, so got a few odd fittings in here, but just a barb 13mm, I think they're a 1/2 inch fitting going out to the tap, and then some blue stripe. This is the pressure pipe that's used for plumbing. I've pretty much all just drilled some 1/8 holes in there for now, put an end cap on there, zip tied it to the end of the barrel, and yeah, that's pretty much all the water delivery system for both of them. Got another 2 taps involved here just so I can regulate the flow. This is the other barrel, 3 more ginger. This ginger is plants that we grew last year and they just started to shoot, so we always keep a few aside to plant out again, even though we've got it growing in the garden still. Same arrangement on this one here, so I'm pretty happy. Again, just through the 20mm pipe, a different fitting on this one because it's all I had and I didn't want to spend any money, and I've just made up a little bit of a bracket just to keep it nice and solid, so more than happy with that. As far as whether it's going to work or not with the ginger, I don't know. But you know, if I had a tomato in here or a capsicum or something like that, or a sweet pepper for those overseas, I'm sure it would do absolutely fantastically. The drain's working fine on this flow rate. Just give you a look down this end. There we go, coming out there. As for going with the 90mm, well, it's definitely a lot easier on the pocket than the 50mm, which was the other option. If I want to put Uniseals in here at any point in time, I can pop them into the 90mm. I could, I'd be pushing it, putting them into the 50mm pipe, but yeah, they can definitely go into this 90mm. As for what I've filled them with, I've pretty much all used a whole heap of clay media that was underneath the house from a bed. If you've seen my earlier clips, I had a failed bed behind this one here, just a half barrel. Very mucky and led to all sorts of problems. So I used the clay, there was enough there to fill up this barrel and a little bit of this barrel. The rest of this media here has come from this grow bed. That really doesn't do it justice. Believe me, guys, that is one mucky grow bed. So that's a 2-year-old one. Had some perennial plants in there, so a lot of roots and a lot of solids have accumulated. I could have made it cheaper on myself by going out and buying some river rocks and putting a layer of river rocks, large ones, probably 50 to 100 mil, so what's that, 2 to 4 inches in size, put a layer of them on the bottom, then some shade cloth, and then dump the clay on top. That would have worked as well and saved me, you know, quite a few dollars in clay, but I've got more than enough clay for the build here, so I'm pretty happy with using this. You'll see how this gets cleaned up later, I think. So there you go, guys, there's a bit of a look at the bucket build. Like I said, if this ginger doesn't work out, I can pop some other plants in there, so stay tuned to the vlogs just to see how they go. Thinking Warrigal greens would work really well in here. But other than that, if you do have any questions, comments or suggestions about this build, or any of the other aquaponics we do around the place, leave a comment in the comments section below and I'll try and get back to you as soon as I can. Otherwise, I hope you all have an absolutely fantastic week and I shall catch you next time. Cheers, guys!